This is the Apostles' Creed in American Sign Language. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let's go to the jungle, and this is our plan. Discovering secrets made by the great I Am. Journey from Genesis to Revelation, to know where you're going and learn where we began. Let's go! Hey, hey, hey! Can you hear our jungle jam? Hey, hey, hey! We began with the great I Am. Hey, hey, hey! Can you hear our jungle jam? Hey, hey, hey! We began with the great I Am. Oh, 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 oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, journey from Genesis to Revelation, to know where you're going and learn where we began. Let's go!
Hey, hey, hey!
Can you hear our jungle jam?
Hey, hey, hey!
We began with the great I Am.
Hey, hey, hey!
Can you hear our jungle jam?
Hey, hey, hey!
We began with the great I Am.
Oh,
eternity. that's where I'll be for eternity. And there'll be peace, so much peace. And there'll be love, oh love, love, love. And there'll be joy, so much joy. No more crying, no more pain, no more brokenness and shame. There'll be peace and love and laughter, no more sorrow and pain. There'll be joy forever after under Jesus' reign. That's where I'll be for eternity. And there'll be peace, so much peace. And there'll be love, oh love, love, love. And there'll be joy, so much joy. No more crying, no more pain, no more brokenness and shame. There'll be peace and love and laughter, no more sorrow and pain. There'll be joy forever after under Jesus' reign. That's where I'll be for eternity. Jesus came and in his name salvation is found. There'll be peace and love and laughter, no more sorrow and pain. There'll be joy forever after under Jesus' reign. That's where I'll be for eternity. Yeah. Come on. There'll be peace and love and laughter, no more sorrow and pain. There'll be joy forever after under Jesus' reign. That's where I'll be for eternity. There'll be peace and love and laughter, no more sorrow and pain. There'll be joy forever after under Jesus' reign. That's where I'll be for eternity. For eternity.
welcome to Yongnak Kids Worship Time. Welcome back, children. It is so good to see you. I'm so glad that you are here to worship together. Let's start the worship with a prayer. Let's pray. Heavenly Father God, thank you for bringing each and every one of us here today to worship you. Lord, please forgive all our sins with the blood of Jesus and fill us up with your Holy Spirit. Lord, as we worship you, please come and touch us and heal us and be glorified through us. Lord, we love you and we thank you. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, boys and girls, today's sermon title is God Provided for Hannah. The sermon comes from the book of 1 Samuel. So where is the book of 1 Samuel? Is it in the Old Testament or New Testament? Yes, it is in the Old Testament. Let's read from chapter 1 through 3. The verses that we will cover today is from 1 Samuel chapter 1, verses 10 and 11. Let's read together. Deeply hurt, Hannah prayed to the Lord and wept with many tears. Making a vow, she pleaded, Lord of hosts, if you will take notice of your servant's affliction, remember and not forget me, and give your servant a son, I will give him to the Lord all the days of his life, and his hair will never be cut. Amen. Next verse that we will cover is from the 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 2. There is no one holy like the Lord. There is no one besides you. And there is no rock like our God. Hi kids, I'm so glad you are here today. As you know, my name is Jessica. Every time we meet together, we hear a true story from what book? That's right, Bible. We hear a story, true story from the Bible. The Bible isn't just a book, it's God's holy word. There are so many exciting and interesting stories in God's word. Today's story begins with a woman named Hannah who prayed to God. God heard Hannah's prayer and answered it in an amazing way. I can't wait to tell you all about it.
Does anyone remember our big picture question? Remember, each week we like to think about an important question, and we answer that question by looking in God's word. Our big picture question is, what is the payment for sin? Does anyone remember the answer? The answer is the fair payment for sin is death. God's word reveals who he is. God's word says in Romans 6:23 that the payment for sin is death. It doesn't end there though. The Bible tells us that God, because of his love for us, offers us salvation from sin through Jesus. Today we'll see how God used someone named Samuel to tell people what God is like and how, later, God will use his son to show the world that he is like, what he is like.
Several weeks ago, we heard how God's people were caught in a cycle of sin. Even in their sin, God continued to care for his people. Then we saw how God used Samson to rescue his people from their enemies. Last week, we saw how God provided a kinsman redeemer for Ruth. Today, we will see how God heard the prayer of a woman named Hannah and how he provided for her and continues to provide for his people.
In a land called Ephraim, a man named Elkanah lived with his wife Hannah. Hannah was sad because she really wanted children, but she didn't have any. Every year, Elkanah went to the tabernacle to make sacrifices to God and to worship him. Hannah went with him. She prayed, Lord, if you give me a son, I will dedicate him to you. He will serve you all of his life. A priest named Eli sat nearby and watched Hannah pray. He couldn't hear her, but he saw her lips moving. Eli thought something was wrong with Hannah. I've been pouring out my heart before the Lord, she explained. So Eli replied, Go in peace. May God answer your prayers. Hannah and Elkanah returned home, and God answered her prayers. After some time, Hannah gave birth to a son. She named the baby Samuel. When Samuel was a little older, Hannah took him to Eli at the tabernacle. "God answered my prayers," she said. Hannah pledged Samuel to serve God, and she worshiped God. Then Hannah went back home and left Samuel with Eli to serve God. Every year, Hannah returned with a new robe for Samuel. God gave Hannah many more children, too. One night, Eli was in his bed and Samuel was lying in the tabernacle when Samuel heard someone call his name. "Here I am," Samuel replied. He ran to Eli. "Here I am, you called me." But it wasn't Eli. He told Samuel to go back to bed. God called Samuel three times, and each time Samuel ran to Eli. "Here I am," he said. Eli finally understood that God was calling to Samuel. He told Samuel how to respond. So Samuel went back to his place, and God called, "Samuel, Samuel." This time, Samuel spoke up. "Speak, for your servant is listening." God told Samuel that he was going to judge Eli's family for their sin. Eli's sons served as priests in the tabernacle, but they were sinning against God. The next day, Samuel was afraid to tell Eli what God had said, but he shared God's message with Eli. As Samuel grew, God was with him. Everyone in Israel knew that Samuel was God's messenger. God used Samuel to share his plan with the nation of Israel. Hannah trusted God and sent Samuel away from home to serve God with his whole life. God sent Jesus from heaven to earth to be our Savior. Just as Samuel used God's words to tell people about God, Jesus, the Word who became flesh, perfectly shows us what God is like.
What an amazing story! The story of Hannah and Samuel shows us how God loves, cares, and provides for His children. Open your Bible to 1 Samuel chapter 1. Let's look at verses 10 and 11. "Deeply hurt, Hannah prayed to the Lord and wept with many tears. Making a vow, she pleaded, 'Lord of hosts, if you will take notice of your servant's affliction, remember and not forget me, and give your servant a son, I will give him to the Lord of the days of his life, and his hair will never be cut.'" Hannah was very upset. In her sadness, she chose to cry out to the Lord through prayer. God heard Hannah's prayer and gave her a son, Samuel. Now, find chapter 2 in First Samuel and look at verse 2. First Samuel chapter 2 verse 2. "There is no one holy like the Lord. There is no one besides you, and there is no rock like our God." Hannah knew that it was the Lord who heard her prayer and answered her. Have you ever prayed and wondered if God really heard your prayers? Did you think He would ever answer that? One of the ways we can get to know God more is through His Word. The Bible tells us that He hears us when we pray and that He will answer in just the right way, at just the right time. God wants to have a relationship with us, and one of the best ways to develop that relationship is by talking to Him and trusting Him through prayer. Samuel used God's words to tell the people what God is like. Book of John chapter 1 verse 1 says that Jesus is the Word. "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." Jesus, the Son of God, told the world about God's plan and showed what God is like.
Let no one despise your youth. Instead, you should be an example to the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity. Samuel was a young boy when God first started speaking to him with messages for God's people. God sometimes calls kids to do big things for him. If you think you can't have much of an impact in the church or in sharing the gospel, think again. The Bible tells us that even when we're young, we can set an example for other people.
Let's read today's key passage. Today's key passage is from the book of Romans, chapter 6, verse 23. Let's read together. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Our key passage reminds us that salvation and eternal life is a gift from God through Jesus. Let's work on hiding the verse in our hearts. Let's pray, everyone. Heavenly Father God, thank you for always hearing our prayers and for providing everything we need for eternal life. You provided us with the free gift of salvation through your Son, Jesus. Help us live in a way that brings glory and honor to you. We love you and we thank you. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. It's time to bring our offering. We can give offering through online or drop it at church. Let's give our offering with our hearts. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father God, thank you for giving us an opportunity to give this monetary offering to you. Lord, please accept this offering in our hearts and use it for your glory. Please expand your kingdom and build your churches. Lord, please remember all the missionaries on the field and please provide their needs and help them and be with them. And Lord, please comfort them. Lord, please remember Yongnak Church, Yongnak Education Department, and in Yongnak Church Kids Ministry. Lord, please use us to glorify your name. Lord, please be with us and use us. Lord, we love you and we thank you. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, boys and girls, now let's end the service by reciting the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. All right, boys and girls, welcome. And thank you for giving worship with us. I have a few announcements to share with you. We have EBS coming up, so make sure to contact your friends and neighbors so they can come out and listen to the gospel and have fun with us. And there's children's choir, so it's growing, and it has reached about 20 students, so please come out and join the choir if you're interested. Please stay safe and healthy in Jesus, and I'll see you next time.